Hello and welcome back to Space Engineers on the Xbox, on the Series X. A quick tutorial this morning, talking all about inventory management. A couple of things I wanted to touch on, including how to make this automated sorting system here so that you can still pull materials and other things onto your ship from your headquarters. So I'm back on my temporary base on my creative save that I've had ever since pretty much owning the game last year. And this particular one has some cargo boxes. This cargo box here full of gubbins. Got this one here. Has a bunch of parts and stuff in it. This cargo conveyor sorter here, which sorts iron ingots. And this one, if I remember rightly, sorts nickel, silicon, wafers, and cobalt. And that one up there is for stone. And they shove all of those into these boxes. Basically, allowing you to put stuff into this ship, connect it up, and throw it into the system. But when you're using conveyor sorters, as I said before, imagine them in X-ray vision with lots of cogs and various things pulling goods through. They don't allow you to pull goods back. So in this inventory management tutorial, I wanted to show you, first of all, advanced inventory management. So let's grab a few things. I'm just going to grab these because they won't get pulled through the system due to the conveyor sorters. I just want to grab a few parts. And maybe the ice, the iron ingots. So, yeah. If you look at your cargo boxes, you'll see you have this screen in your inventory. Now, look at the bottom. You can add any of your inventory items to production. So, you know, construction computers, so on. You can transfer items between two inventories. So if I wanted to put these bulletproof glass into that medium cargo container 3 on my little ship, I would simply just make sure that I flick the left stick across to the right hand side and back again and press A once. That will let me move 42k of bulletproof glass into that box, and that is it, because that's the maximum it can hold, pretty much. If I wanted to pull it out again, I'd press A. If I wanted to only put 10 on, I could hold the left bumper and hit A, and I'd transfer 10 over. If I wanted to transfer 100, it would be the right bumper to transfer 100, and 1,000 would be both bumpers and A. I could deposit all of the items by pressing the inventory button, and it'll tell me that two components could not be deposited because there's not enough room for them. Pull them back out again, and you'll notice that it tried to put as much as it could in. What we have then here, however, are two inventories. There's my character's inventory and my ship's inventory. it will always open to the filter you select, though. So if you click in the left stick, you will change the left hand side filter. And the active filter at the moment is called character. If we want to specifically choose our ship, we need to change the right filter until it says ship. And now you can see we have the medium cargo container, my pod connector, and the control seat. Bear in mind, control seats aren't linked to the main inventories. Only these two are linked on this little ship. If I press it again, we'll go to any storage inventory in the whole grid, any empty boxes and connectors. And if I move across to hide empty and activate that radio button, then you'll only see the inventories that are full. Of course, you can't actually pull any of this back to your inventory. You can only send things through the system to another cargo container. So, for instance, if we wanted to put our construction computers into small cargo container 3, we'd make sure we highlighted small cargo container 3 with the left stick, then flick the left stick across, use the D-pad until we got to the construction computers, and try to put them in. You'll notice something there. It's because we've got a conveyor sorter in the way. Before I move on to those and how to potentially avoid this, I wanted to talk a little bit more about these filters. Your last filter is your system or ship or station system inventories. Again, you can hide all the empty. You can search for a specific thing and get what you want. So if you were just looking for cobble, you could search for cobble. Let's unhide empty again and click back. So each time you click the right stick in, you will change the inventory filter. Very useful if you want to get directly to a specific inventory. The same for the left stick. You can change the inventory. So if you're trying to manipulate cargo between two ships, and one ship is docked to a station via a connector or whatever, or two ships are connected via connectors, you can make the left filter into the ship and the right filter into a ship, and then pick the correct cargo containers that way. But if you've got any sorters in the way, they will prevent smooth flow of cargo. They're useful, though, for taking things like that ice I've got there, pulling it through the system, and like the iron bars, doing the same. But they won't pull these components through unless you tell them to. You could have a conveyor sorter on drain all and select every single component that you want pulled through the system on a whitelist. I've shown you how to use these in the past. I'm not going to repeat that in this one. You'll find the tutorial on my channel. I'll link to it in the description. What we want, though, is we want to be able to pull this cargo here, say our steel plates, back out of the system onto our little ship there without needing to mess about. The best way to do it, you'll see that I have a cargo container here. Now, that cargo container is separate from my original system, yet still part of it due to the conveyor there. However, all of this stuff is linked via those conveyors and cargo boxes together, which means that cargo container there with the ice in, if I then look at my system, I could bring out a connection here. This. A green light. Now, there's a bypass pipe running into that system. So if we go back to our cargo container here, and we change the filter, as I've just shown you how to do, and we hide all the empty containers, and we change it to just cargo container storage. Things are moving around the system. We wanted, say, our steel plates. So if we select our small cargo container 4 in this regard and press A, we can now pull our steel plates from cargo container 4 into our inventory. We can also put them, the bulletproof glass, the computers, and the construction computers in cargo container 4. We can take out the metal grids. We can select cargo container 5 and put the metal grids there. Because what we've done is we bypassed our sorters, which are still working. Now we have a direct link into our pipe from the ship to our headquarters into this box. So if you're going to create a system that involves sorters, if you ensure that there is also a link on your system that goes from a conveyor port into a cargo container or another conveyor port on that same system, you can still use conveyor sorters to pull things like stone and iron from your ship. But you can now things in manually, pull them out manually, while still maintaining your cargo container ability to pull ice and other goods through the system. Once more, from the top, hide the empties. There's the ice we just put in, so we can take that back out. And always make sure that the inventory that you're trying to pull from is highlighted and you've got the correct filter selected. It'll make life easier in the long run. And that is the advanced inventory management tutorial. Hopefully you'll find that of some use. Stay tuned for the next one, because I'm going to be taking a look at a mod. And just as a quick sneaky peek, we've seen Zat's Kitchen. Now, I'm going to be looking at some new build options for stations and ships from Corsive Corridors. I'll reveal more about that mod in the actual video, including the author, because this has been uploaded by somebody with the permission of a Steam author. So, until then, stay safe, take care, have fun, enjoy the game, and as I always say, keep your eye out for Warfare news. I'm pretty sure we're going to see something fairly soon about Warfare 2. This is the year of war. Bye.